Hey guys, so I just wanted to show you how I make Spanish bean soup, white Spanish bean soup. Hold on one second. I'm gonna put you down. We'll go from here. Ingredients. So we're gonna turn on the stove. Number 8. Olive oil. Squirt, squirt. A little bit of butter. Let that get hot. And you're gonna need your crock pot today too. Or whenever you decide to make it. I'm gonna do the same thing to this. Put some butter in. Add some flavoring. Olive oil. Yep, yep. The only thing that I don't like about this. Oh, right. Sausage. I get 2 packs because, you know, my son loves this stuff. So we're gonna cut this up first. They make these packages so you can't get into them. All right, and I usually just cut it on the bottom package. Cut them like this, and then we're gonna cut like this. So we're gonna cut it in halves. That's gonna be in just a minute. Maybe right now, because I'm running out of room. So, melting. Everything is melting, melting, melting. Beautifully. So at the bottom, I always put dried garlic. Regular garlic, because we love garlic. A little bit of black pepper in there. Onion powder. And I do no salt. Now, I do no salt because it helps with the sodium. That's my son. Hi. Okay, so I'm gonna throw these in. Normally he helps me, but he's also doing his YouTube channel, DTR Reviews. I just want to say, Annie E, could you leave me your Instagram site in my comments so I can go and request you, because I looked you up and I couldn't find you. Now, I would say this usually feeds around about 4 people. But when you have a 13-year-old boy who eats you out of a house and home, this will only feed 1 person, including him.
What?
He is that 1 person. Just gonna throw that out there. I love you, but
love you too.
I know. And he has already opened the cans for me because he's very nice like that sometimes. Yep. When we start getting this cooked, I'll show you what else you do. Now, you don't have to use this. You can use whatever you want. You can use turnip greens, collard greens. I use collard greens because I'm Southern and I love collard greens. Mmm. Smell of that garlic. One down. And if you think that it's getting too dry in there, pour a little more. Olive oil does not hurt you. Gonna open the last one. Should have opened them both at the same time. Bella, can you get me the scissors, baby? Never mind.
Never mind, Bubba.
Do you need help?
No!
Yeah, guys, I just took a really big turd.
You're disgusting.
We should get that checked for you, because that is a long turd.
Ew, and it's raw and everything.
That's disgusting.
My turds are gross.
So, I'm going to turn it down to 5 now. The only reason I turned it up to 8 was to get the pot, or the pan heated. And I just want to caramelize this stuff. That's really all I want to do. Mmm, the smell of those collard greens. Woo! I just want to tear them open. Now, you can do this with canned collard greens, which is what I'm going to do today. But I would rather cook my collard greens first, fresh collard greens, and then make this. But I just want to throw this together for you, show you, and then go from there. Now, you want to just caramelize these first, because in a minute you're going to throw them in with the collard greens. And I usually use white beans, but I couldn't find them this time, so I just used northern beans. And if you do want to, you can make homemade garlic bread. Oh, I love it. With Italian bread, or you can make some cornbread. It just depends on what you like. Me, I like everything. I love cornbread. I love garlic bread. Almost finished. And while this is simmering, we're gonna get the other stuff started. We're gonna put it in the crock pot today. And I like to cook it for about 3 or 4 hours on low. Amazing. Okay. Now that we've got that started, let me get the piece that fell into the butter. Okay. Yes, normally I wash my hands, but the sink is way over there. So here's my collard greens. I'm gonna dump them in. And today I'm only using 3 cans. You can use as many as you want. It depends on how many you're feeding, who likes it, who doesn't, all that. So those are those.
And then we have, these are Great Northern beans, but I usually get white beans, whatever you like. Now, I always drain the collard greens, but I never drain the beans because I want all of the juices to combine. Some water. Shake it around, get the rest of the collard greens. It's only water. This is just water. Right. So in there, in the crock pot, we're going to put more pepper. You can put as much or as little, or you don't even have to put any. It just depends on what you like. Some no salt, because like I said, there's so much salt in here that we just want to balance it out. Onion powder. Bubba, can you give me the garlic powder, baby?
I sure can.
Thank you. Shake, shake, shake.
What?
Here, baby. Oh. And you can't go wrong with a little bit of hot sauce. I would say a dab, but my son and I, we love it hot. So I'm just going to put a dab. Just a little dab. Not much. You know, just to cover the top. Just a dab. And garlic. Guess what? I'm going to turn off my stove. Get these out of the way. Because I just want to show you. I feel like there's a camera crew in here with my son. I'm not joking.
That's me.
Okay, let's put this right over here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take all of the juices from the sausage, and I'm just going to pour it in here. Because you want every flavor from everything. You want collard green flavor, you want bean flavor, you want the sausage flavor, you want everything in there. Because in the end, 4 hours later, 3 hours later, you are going to, oh, your mouth is going to water. No lie. All right. Stir it up real good.
Tell me that doesn't already look amazing.
I can't tell you that when it looks amazing.
Thank you. There you have it. Spanish white bean soup. Cook it for 4 hours.
And done so. Have a great day, guys. Bye.